Hello everyone, I'm Nawaz Sarwar and today we'll go through the introduction as well as the hello world part of the Java programming language. So you may already know much about the Java, but I would like to reiterate that Java is a programming language which is robust, powerful, object oriented, and it has a very good history and a vibrant community of developers who use this programming language. It was built to scale, you may say that. And the best part about it is that it is a cross-platform. Actually, the original idea that some microsystems took while designing this language was that there should be a language which should be a cross-platform. So you can write it once and run it everywhere else. Can be run on various platforms like Mac operating systems and Windows and Linux and many others. So I think there is already a lot of literature available about Java and its history. I would not be going into much detail on that, and I think you can go through the Google search engine and find more about it. I think we should start our Hello World traditional program to get this up. So as you can see that I have already installed NetBeans or Oracle Java, and I should be letting you how to check it. You can fire up your terminal or command prompt on your Windows operating system and write java-version. And you would see something similar, and if there is any error, it means that Java is not installed, or it may be, you know, the environment is not properly set up. So as you can see that I have already installed and my Java is version 8 and we are good to go. So I'll start with the Hello World program. I'll select the Java application. Next, I'll name it . You can choose your location from here, whatever directory you want, and then create a main class and then finish. As you can see that it already generates a class, and it already has few sections with lots of comments. I would like to delete it so that it does not confuse as much. Every Java application starts with a class. And normally the class name is the name of the project, and every Java application at least should have a main method which should be static. It is the starting point for any Java application, and it should have the following string array as an argument to be available there. So system.out will do our traditional thing. And after saving it, I'll click on the run button. As you may see that the build was successful, and it says that, and it has displayed the output, which is hello world. So I think our Java environment is properly set up, our NetBeans integrated development environment is already set up, and we are good to go for our future endeavors. See you in the next video.